Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. This is part two, showing how to create the look of Andy Warhol-style pop art portraits from photos. Picking up from where we left off, scroll to your dot halftone layer and make it active. Click the new layer icon to make a new layer above it. Click your foreground color to open the color picker. Pick a color you'd like for the border. Since I already know the color I want, I'll type it into the hexadecimal field. Open your brush tool and brush picker. Click the gear icon and click Thick Heavy Brushes, which is a set that comes with Photoshop. When you see this message, click OK to replace your current brushes with the Thick Heavy Brushes. I'll click this brush, but feel free to try other brushes in this set. If you're using this brush as well, rotate its angle approximately this much. To make more room for your brush, let's zoom out a bit. Press and hold Ctrl or Command plus the minus key on your keyboard. Loosely brush around your document, overlapping the edges. To fit your document back onto your canvas, press Ctrl or Command 0. Next, we'll add a brushed background behind your subject. Make a new layer below the border by Alt-clicking or Option-clicking the New Layer icon. Click your foreground color and pick a color for your background. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. As before, brush in the color and avoid overlapping it onto your subject. Next, we'll brush in a color over the face. Keep in mind, Warhol often used bright garish colors for the skin and hair of his subjects, so feel free to experiment and have fun with the colors. Make a new layer. I'll change its blend mode to linear light, but again, feel free to try other blend modes. Click the foreground color and pick a color for the face. I'll make my brush bigger by pressing the right bracket key on my keyboard and loosely brush over the face. Don't be concerned about the color overlapping too much on the rest of your subject. We'll take care of that next. Click the layer mask icon to make a layer mask next to the face color. Notice that your foreground and background colors defaulted back to black and white respectively as soon as you click the layer mask icon. Make your brush smaller by pressing the left bracket key on your keyboard and loosely brush over the areas of the blue color that you want to hide. I'll reduce the size of my brush and brush over the teeth. If you want to add color to your subject's lips, first make a new layer. Notice your foreground color reverted back to the color you picked for the face. Click the foreground color and pick a color for the lips. Now, loosely brush over them. Next, we'll color the hair. Make a new layer. Since Elvis's hair is dark, I'll change the blend mode to multiply, but choose whatever suits you for your subject. Click the foreground color and pick a color for the hair. I'll increase its size and brush over the hair. Next, we'll add text. Scroll to the top layer and make it active. Open your horizontal type tool and pick a font. I'm using Kevin Wilde Regular. If you'd like to use it as well, I provided its link in my video's description or project files. I'll make its size 68 points. Smooth and left alignment. Click the color box and pick a color. Click on your document and type out your text. To reposition it, open your Move tool and move it. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.